GPT-3, Generative Pre-trained Transformer, is a third-generation AI model developed by the OpenAI company. It is a large-scale neural network you can use to generate text and code. With SendPulse, on a paid plan, you can connect GPT-3 to your chatbot to provide your users with even more proficient automated replies and help them solve additional tasks. Let's learn how to create an OpenAI account and connect it to your chatbot, and find out what AI models you can use and how to train your bot to solve your business tasks. Go to OpenAI and create an account. Click Sign Up, enter your email address, and click Continue. Or continue with your Google or Microsoft account. If you entered your email address, enter a password in the next window. You will receive a confirmation email in your inbox. Click Verify in the email and enter your name, the name of your organization, and your phone number. A confirmation code will be sent to it via SMS. Enter the code and log into your account. Before choosing a phone number to use, check OpenAI's list of supported countries and territories. You can find a link in the description below. Next, you need to copy your API key. In the upper right corner of the account, click on the avatar, select Manage Account, and in the API Keys tab, click Create New Secret Key. Copy the key. You need to save a key on your device because you cannot copy the same key on this page a second time. If you lose the key, you will need to generate a new one. To connect the integration, select a bot in your SendPulse account. Go to Bot Settings, Integrations. Next to OpenAI, click Enable. Enter your key. Choose what AI model to use to generate bot replies. There are four primary models that can perform different tasks, starting with complex text analysis to generating replies on various topics. ADA, the fastest and cheapest model. Use it when you need to parse text faster without too much nuance, correct the address, or search for keywords. Babbage is good at picking up obvious text patterns and using them as references to generate new text. The model is able to classify information, assign categories, and create simple plots and titles. Curie is suitable for translation, answering direct questions in chatbots, or analyzing the sentiment of a text. Davinci, the most comprehensive yet expensive and slower model, as it works with a large amount of data, can solve logic problems, analyze cause and effect problems, generalize, explain, and generate code. It can perform the same tasks as other models. To limit certain topics, you don't want your bot to discuss and add text sentiment or information about your company. You need to add prompts. In the Bot Instructions field, provide your freeform prompts following the recommendations. If you need the bot to answer in a certain way, provide examples of questions and answers. If you want your model to answer in a certain language, specify it. The bot will answer in English by default. Try to use words instead of figures. AI does not have a long memory. When processing a request, only the last couple of user messages are taken into account. We recommend you monitor your bot's conversations with customers to correct its prompts. If you have any questions about how to create bot prompts or possible scenarios, you can check existing discussions or start a new one in the OpenAI community. For more details, please follow the link in the description below. Add a token number. Token is a part of a word used for natural language processing. For English text, one token equals approximately 4 characters or 0.75 words. For each request, the token count takes into account the number of words in the following places. In the bot prompt field, in the last messages in a chat with a bot, in the current question that a user asks a bot, in the current answer that a bot provides a user with. During the first registration, OpenAI gives $18 for 3 months. This money will be withdrawn when you use tokens. Token fees vary depending on the model used. For more information about OpenAI's pricing plans, click on the link in the description below. In the maximum number of tokens in response field, specify a number. For the DaVinci model, you can enter up to 2,048 tokens, and for all other models, up to 1,024 tokens. Click Save, and you can test your bot. To see how many tokens you have left, log in to your OpenAI account and go to the Usage tab. To check your token usage history, scroll the page down to the Daily Usage Breakdown UTC section. you can see the whole history or filter it by specific date or team member. Please note that when you integrate with OpenAI, your standard reply flow will be disabled for your chatbot. Therefore, you need to make sure users know that your bot can reply to them. For example, add your bot communication guidelines to a welcome or trigger flow that you add to your menu. AI does not integrate with additional applications and does not process client data in your bot's audience. For these features, create commands to run flows where you can add the user input, API request, and action elements, or add a menu. Let's see various examples of how you can use a chatbot with an OpenAI integration. If you have a bot for a feature-loaded service and have collected an FAQ database, you can teach your bot to give answers when requested. For our first example, we use the Davinci model with 2,048 tokens. We added short info about the company, its business, and contacts. The bot can develop a dialogue based on the data received. For the second example, the Davinci model used 800 tokens. In the bot instructions field, we added basic questions and answers to them. Users don't have to ask these questions verbatim, and the AI will know enough about your business to be able to answer naturally. If you have a student helper bot, users can add their task and indicate what needs to be solved. For example, the Davinci model used 800 tokens. In the bot instructions field, we added prompts that do not allow the bot to answer non-math related questions. If you have an SMM or SEO tool, your bot can help users choose keywords or proofread and optimize the entered text for SEO. For example, the ADA model used 1,024 tokens. In the bot instructions field, we added prompts that allow the bot optimize text for SEO and search for keywords. If users do not run a command, the bot will remind them how to work with it. If you teach programming, your bot can help users decode parts of code or errors and tell you how a particular element or function works. Also, users can ask your bot to generate code using natural language. For example, the Davinci model used 800 tokens. In the bot instructions field, we added prompts that allow the bot to decrypt and explain code or parts of code. We also added a tone so that the bot responds in a sarcastic manner using simple words. If you have a creative marketing agency, your bot can offer to generate text for an advertising campaign or come up with a brand name and so on. For example, the Curie model used 1,024 tokens. In the bot instructions field, we wrote that bot works at a marketing agency and helps clients create advertising slogans and create plans. For more examples of how you can use a chatbot with an OpenAI integration, follow the link in the description below.